Christ is our hope and our strength. You are listening to Eastertide Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace, siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Stay tuned.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Friday, the 23rd of April, 2021, third week of Easter. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who have come to know the grace of the Lord's resurrection may, through the love of the Spirit, ourselves rise to newness of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Our first reading will be taken by Gabriel Mubiru, a Daily Bread member from Lugazi, Uganda.
He is a chosen instrument of mine to carry my name before the Gentiles. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9, verses 1 to 20. In those days, Saul, still breathing threats and murder against the disciples of the Lord, went to the high priest and asked him for letters to the synagogues at Damascus, so that if he found any belonging to the way, men or women, he might bring them bound to Jerusalem. Now as he journeyed, he approached Damascus, and suddenly a light from heaven flashed about him, and he fell to the ground and heard a voice saying to him, Saul, Saul, why do you persecute me? And he said, Who are you, Lord? And he said, I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting. But rise and enter the city, and you will be told what you are to do. The men who were traveling with him stood speechless, hearing the voice but seeing no one. Saul arose from the ground, and when his eyes were opened, he could see nothing. So they led him by the hand and brought him into Damascus. And for 3 days he was without sight, and neither ate nor drank. Now there was a disciple at Damascus named Ananias. The Lord said to him in a vision, Ananias, and he said, Here I am, Lord. And the Lord said to him, Rise and go to the street called Straight, and inquire in the house of Judas for a man of Tarsus named Saul. For behold, he is praying, and he has seen a man named Ananias come in and lay his hands on him, so that he might regain his sight. But Ananias answered, Lord, I have heard from many about this man, how much evil he has done to your saints at Jerusalem. And here he has authority from the chief priests to bind all who call upon your name. But the Lord said to him, Go, for he is a chosen instrument of mine to carry my name before the Gentiles and kings and the sons of Israel. For I will show him how much he must suffer for the sake of my name. So Ananias departed and entered the house, and laying his hands on him, he said, Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the road by which you came, has sent me that you may regain your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit. And immediately something like scales fell from his eyes, and he regained his sight. Then he rose and was baptized, and took food and was strengthened. For several days he was with the disciples at Damascus and in the synagogues. Immediately he proclaimed Jesus, saying, He is the Son of God. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our gospel passage will be taken by Father Augustine Chochoma, a Daily Bread member from the Archdiocese of Blantyre, Malawi.
My flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
John chapter 6, verses 52 to 59. At that time, the Jews disputed among themselves, saying, "How can this man give us his flesh to eat?" So Jesus said to them, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him up at the last day. For my flesh is food indeed, and my blood is drink indeed. He who eats my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me, and I in him. As the living Father sent me, and I live because of the Father, so he who eats me will live because of me. This is the bread which came down from heaven, not such as the fathers ate and died. He who eats this bread will live forever." This he said in the synagogue as he taught at Capernaum. The Holy Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
The discourse on the fourth sign continues. And this time Jesus is very categorical. He has moved in the direction of the Eucharist. They murmur. They don't understand what he is referring to. And so they murmur. Remember, the listeners of John's gospel, or those who were listening to Jesus as he spoke, would understand him on a different level when he is speaking on a higher level. When he is speaking on a higher level, he is speaking on a spiritual level, they understand him on the physical level. How can this man make us eat his flesh? Are we cannibals? Is he reducing us to cannibals? No, we are not cannibals. We don't want to eat of his flesh. And so he tells them, listen, I want you to understand. Truly, truly, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you have no life in you. Because his flesh and blood are life. Eating of him and drinking of him, we have life. You are what you eat, says Fulbeck, one of the philosophers of materialistic German who influenced Karl Marx, says you are what you eat. Whatever food you feed yourself with is what will make you. And he's right. I'm telling you, if you are eating Christ in your life, if you are feeding on Christ in your life, you become Christ-like. You become Christish. And Christ is life. There is no death in him. He has overcome death. Because he has overcome death, when you are eating of him, when you are relishing from what he is, you become that. The food you eat makes you. Because the food you eat makes you, so if you are eating Christ, you become like Christ. Everything is Christ-like. Your attitude changes. Your attitude towards life changes. You become more optimistic. And as you become more optimistic, longevity of life is assured. You just see years passing and you are wondering, how is it that I am still alive when I thought I would have died many years ago? It is because you have started feeding on him who has life eternal. And so you start already experiencing that eternity on earth. I'm telling you, this is true. This happens. If you are feeding on Christ, even your character will be attuned to Christ-like character. I'm telling you. And so Jesus wants them to understand this. You know what? If you are feeding on me, you're going to embrace the Christ-like characters. You are going to embrace my personality. People are going to see that compassion and love in you that I have for humanity. People are going to see the way you even dispose yourself to others. And People are going to see your sacrificing spirit. They are going to see the way you live for others because you are eating me. I look at people who are vegetarian and those who are cannibals, who eat meat all the time. There is a difference in character because we are what we eat. If we are what we eat and we constantly feed on Christ, there is something that changes about us. We breathe out life. We breathe out joy in our lives because of that which we feed on every day. And so he says, for my flesh is true food and my blood is true drink. Whoever feeds on my flesh and drinks my blood abides in me and I in him. People are going to see something special about you. When you feed on Christ, people are going to see there is something extraordinary about the way you conduct yourself. And this is what we want to see coming out forcefully in us. Look at the first reading of today. Saul is breathing out fury. He's out to destroy. He's determined to do what he thinks was right. And Jesus comes to him and says, you know what? Stop doing this to me. Who are you, Lord? I'm Jesus of Nazareth, whom you are persecuting. Because you are persecuting those who are feeding on me. You are persecuting those who, because they are eating me, they have become me. I am in them. Why are you persecuting me? And this is exactly what God is going to tell those who are attacking those who feed on Christ. Why are you persecuting me? Saul is shocked. You mean I'm doing this to God? You mean I'm doing this to the source of all life? He's shocked. Why are you persecuting me? Why are you doing this against me? Christ is suffering to this day in the many people who are trying to advocate for life. Christ is suffering today in the innocent babies who are dying in the wombs of their mothers because of their selfishness. And he keeps saying, why are you persecuting me? Why are you destroying me? And I hope you are not part of the soul project in trying to destroy the innocence of Christ. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Friday to you.
Thanks be to God.